micro controller which can control several devices like sensors or anything that can be controlled. So let's get into it. So first of all, we should know the basics of electronics. So what is voltage? Voltage is the potential difference between two points. So for every gadgets we are using, there will be a voltage running. So this is a voltage, and the current, as all you know, current is the rate at which the electrons flow. And resistance, say the electrons are moving, it will be so fast, so the gadget may be damaged. So there should be a resistance. So resistance is the opposition to current flow in the electronic circuit. So first of all, we should know the basic. So what is Ohm's law? So Ohm's law is in Ohm's law, he states that voltage is directly proportional to current at a steady temperature. That is the main point. So the voltage is directly proportional to I. Here R is a constant. So for removing the proportional, we are using R. That is the resistance. So what is the embedded systems? Embedded systems, hardware plus software is called the embedded system. So it consists of input, output, processor, memory unit. So for example, we consider a CPU or the desktop. It consists of many parts like memory unit, the storage, hard disk, SSD, HDD, etc. Then the processor like Intel i3, i5, i7, etc. For output, we are using a monitor, and for input, mouse and keyboard are the inputs. So this is an embedded system. For every electronic system has a hardware system plus the software system. The hardware system runs the software so that it runs on a particular condition. So in embedded system, there are two types, microprocessor and microcontroller. So yeah. Microprocessor. What is a microprocessor and a microcontroller? Here, CPU is a standalone, like RAM or ROM. These are all microprocessor. We can't do anything without a controller. So on the other hand, microcontroller can act as a whole thing. It consists of a microprocessor inside it. So the advantages and disadvantages are microprocessor has a high processing power. On the other hand, microcontroller has a low processing power. Power consumption is high in microprocessor, whereas power consumption is low in microcontroller. In microprocessor, we say 64-bit processors, 32-bit processor and all. But in microcontroller, there are two only, 8-bit and 16-bit microcontrollers. So microprocessor example, we say 8065, 8081, etc., 8085, etc. But whereas 8051 is a microcontroller. It is used to control other things. That is microcontroller. So this is these are the embedded systems we use in our daily life. Like everything we use are embedded systems, like smartphones, car, etc. Then broadcasting, medical ECG, everything are embedded systems only. So here we are going to introduce a new hardware. It is called Node MCU ESP8266. ESP8266. So in this ESP8266 means it is a Wi-Fi module. Where and all you see ESP8266, it is a Wi-Fi module. Here Node MCU means Node is a company. MCU means microcontroller unit. So this is a like Arduino. It is one of the processor. It is similar to Arduino. Here in this Arduino, we have inbuilt Wi-Fi module, and the required voltage to run the module is 3.3 voltage, and the current consumption is 10 microamps to 170 milliamps, and flash memory is 16 MB maximum, 512 KB normal. Integrate it runs in the TCP/IP protocol. So in it has a TCP/IP protocol. It runs in the stack. So the processor name is Tensilia L1106. It is a 32-bit processor. Its processing speed is maximum 160 megahertz, and RAM 32 KB. Now and all it's coming for 80 KB and all. It has a GPIO, general processing input output. GPIO, it has 17 inputs and outputs. So we can use 17 sensors or any other we want to control. So analog to digital digital. So ADC, what is ADC? The analog to digital converter. It has a one analog to digital converter, and it's only one input supports ADC. And you all know IEEE 802.11. It means probably Wi-Fi module. So it supports 802.11. So this is a pin configuration of Node MCU. ESP8266 pin configuration. This is the D10, that is data 10, that is GPIO1. So like that, GPIO16 and GPIOs 1, 2, 3 and till GPIO16. There are 16 input digital inputs and one analog input or output. So in Arduino, we have to code. As we all know, embedded systems is a combination of hardware and software. So we saw the hardware. Now we are going into the software. So this is a IDE. So this is the Arduino IDE. Here we can see many examples. So built-in examples, we can use an Arduino project like LED blinking. So here I would like to introduce the software coding part. So here void setup. This is where the pin configuration setup. So if you want to blink an LED, you have to you have to combine the hardware and the hardware like microcontroller to the LED. So if you are plugging in LED into a say zeroth pin, so you have to say this is a zeroth pin is output. So it sets up the zeroth pin as a output. So here everything we have to set up. This is the part we have to set up. Then this is the loop loop part. Here the code runs like digital write. Digital write is the output part. You are saying the zeroth. You are saying switch on the LED, like digital write zeroth pin high. High means you are switching on. So this is the part where we are giving output. Then here we are delaying. So here we are switching on for like 100 milliseconds. 100 milliseconds is equal to 1 second. So 100 milliseconds is equal to 1 second. So we are waiting for 1 second to switch on the LED, and we are switching off at the next second. So we are switching off and delay for 1 second. So this loop will run like an infinity times until the hardware is powered on. So next we can see this is the part where we are configuring the hardware. So you have to go to preferences and type this. Type this http Arduino ESP8266.com. So if you type this and click OK, and you have to select the board which you are using. So you have to select ESP8266. Then you have to install the library of the ESP8266. So you have to go to boards manager. You have to go to boards manager. Yeah, this is the boards manager and library manager. You have to search for ESP8266 and you have to install it. Like this way, you have to install the ESP8266 boards and ESP8266 library. So if you download it, you can see the NodeMCU 1.0 ESP12E module. So in this we are using ESP12E module. There are so many modules you can buy, according to which you can select anyone. So here is the introduction to LED. You all know what is the diagram for LED. So this is anode, and plus is anode and the minus is cathode. So you have to give only 2.2 volts for an LED. But say we are using a processor CPU. In that there will be a many pins. You can connect any LED to that, but it runs on 12 volt, right? So if you are using an LED to indicate something, you have to give a resistor to it so that it controls the current and gives a proper voltage to that LED. So maximum it accepts 2.2 to 3.3 volts. Next is a LED program. Next is a LED program. So LED program. So as well as I taught to you, this is the voice setup, and here I'm declaring D4, which is the pin number D4 as the output. So it considers pin mode as a D4 as the output. So we are digital writing. Digital writing means output. So we are declaring D4 to be high. So it switches on and delay for 1 second, and it switches off and delay for 1 second. This will run forever until the hardware is powered on. So what is a relay? Here the relay consists of five pins. Like an industrial relay consists of so many pins, but the main concept is this only. Here there will be two coils. There will be one coil. It has two pins. A coil consists of two pins, right? So let's say it is A and B. There are two coils. There are two pins of a coil, and one common and one open and close. So normally open and normally closed. So normally closed means the common and normally closed will always be connected. So normally open will be open. It will not be connected to the common. So consider this diagram. We are connecting to normally open to a bulb, and the bulb is connected to a power source, and the power source is connected to the common. So if you are giving a current or a voltage to the coil, the normally opened, there will be a connection, right? That connection will be induced to normally open. So now when there is a current flowing through the coil, the normally opened and the common pin will be shorted. So it will be connected, the bulb is switching on. And if you are not giving any current or voltage to the coil, it will not be switched on, as the normally open is not connected to the common. So the next topic is MQTT server. The MQTT server, it is a message queuing telemetry transport. What is a message queuing telemetry transport means? If you are posting something, if you are talking to a friend through a letter, you have to post in a post box, and it will be queued in the post office, and it will be transmitted one by one, like that. Here, message queuing telemetry transport means you are sending or receiving something. It will be queued, and it will be transmitted or received one by one. That is a message queuing telemetry transport. The ISO standard is ISO IEC PRF 20922. It is a ISO standard. You have to use this only. So if you are using this, you have to use a publish and a subscribe. Like if you are publishing an article, subscribe to an article. So what is that? Publish and subscribe. So publish means you are publishing, you are transmitting an article. So you are transmitting a data. Likewise, the subscribe means you are subscribing a data. So you are receiving a data. So this is a publish subscribe based message protocol. So it's it works on the top of the TCP IP protocol. So as I said earlier, it works on the TCP IP protocol. The publish subscribe messaging pattern requires a message broker. So here, as I said earlier, when you're sending a letter to the your friend, there will be a post office as a broker, right? It receives the letter and transmitting to your friend. So the here also it receives a message broker. So history of MQTT. Andy of he is working in IBM, and Alan of Cirrus Link authored the first version of MQTT protocol in 1999. In 2013, IBM submitted MQTT version 3.2 the OASIS. You all know the OASIS company, right? And IBM. In 2013, IBM developed. It is a developed by IBM worker, right? Employee, right? So IBM submitted the MQTT version 3.1 to the OASIS. And then it got verified and it got ISO standard, everything. So now you are using that. So why MQTT? So why we are using MQTT? Why it has been declared as ISO standard? So let's see. It is a lightweight publish. It is a lightweight publish and subscribe system where you can send and receive data as a client. So if you want to send and receive data, so there are other processes anything. The ways that other than this are very complicated and complex. Likewise, this is a lightweight, so you can use it very easily. So it establishes a simple communication between multiple devices. So it requires a simple process to communicate between multiple devices like TV, phone, sensors, PC, laptop, everything we can connect using this. So simple messaging protocol designed for constrained devices and low bandwidth devices. So it requires a simple protocol. You don't want to need a big library, or you have to create a library. You don't want all of that. You can use as simple thing. So this is a perfect solution for Internet of Things. We can call this as a IoT workshop, like because it is a Internet of Things application. So there are four concepts in MQTT, like publish and subscribe, message, topics, and brokers. So what is a publish and subscribe? As I told, publish and subscribe means publish means transmitting, subscribe means receiving. So it is a first step. So second step, what you need to be published or subscribed? A message. A message in here in the sense a data. So you are transmitting and receiving a data. And topics. You have to create some topics on this message. Like you will feed anything like TV or CPU or laptop. You can feed sensors. You can feed anything. So it needs a topic, right? Like grouping. Like grouping, you have to group and create a topic for it. And broker, like I said, post office. What is a post office? It acts as a broker to us or our friends to whom we want to send the post. Like that. Let's see the concept. This is the publish and subscribe. So device one. So we are publishing it to the broker. The center part is it is a broker. It will publish and subscribe. So it will publish. We are the device one. Let's say device one is us. So we are publishing it to the broker, and the broker publishes it to the second device. Let's say WhatsApp as an example. We are sending message. So the WhatsApp server access a broker here. So we are sending a message. It's saves on the WhatsApp server. So in the WhatsApp server is sending the message, sending our message to the device too, our friends or family, etc. So this is a publish and subscribe. So what is a message? It is usually a command or data. It is an information exchange between the devices. So let's say a scenario. You have to sense water in a garden. So there is a sensor for the presence of water or not to find it. We have to get the information whether the water is there or not. So the sensor sends if there is a water, say let's say one, it is a data. Say one is equal to that the water is present. So it sends the data to the broker. The broker sends to us the that saying that there is a water in it. So the data is the messages. Here topics. So we are connecting three LANs. So we are connecting three LANs. For example, the topic one, topic two, topic three is the name of the LANs. We can say that. So topic one is the LAN one, topic two is the LAN two, topic three is the LAN three. So we are sending to switch on the LAN one. It takes a LAN one. So when it sends, topic one switch on. So it sends the data to the topic one, the broker. So the first LAN will be switched on. So that's why topics are there. Broker. So what is the main function of the broker? There are three main functions: receive all the messages, sends all the messages, and filters. First of all, it receives and filters and then sends. So there will be a lot of example. For example, say there are five LANs. So you have to switch on the first LAN. So we are sending the data, the broker receives the data that and filters it. Filters in the sense, it filters the which LAN to be switched on. So the first LAN. So it filters and it sends the message to the first LAN alone, not for the other LANs. So it is the filtering process. So this is the working of broker. So here, Adafruit. Let's see the Adafruit. You can go to adafruit.io. So this is the adafruit.io. Let me sign out this. This is the Adafruit.io. It is the input-output website for everything. You can use this. This is a broker. So you can use this as a broker to connect many things. So in this IO, I'm going to start signing up. So you have to sign up for this, and this is totally free. And if I'm already signed in, so I'm directly signing in. So this is the page you will be going. So this is the dashboard. Now I'm creating a new dashboard. So name, let's say home automation. And description, you can give anything. So
we have created a dashboard for an application of home automation. You can give any name you want. Here we can add many blocks as we want. So here there are a lot of blocks. This is a toggle. If you want to switch on something like you have to switch on a lamp or fan or TV or a computer or anything, you can select this. Or if you have to reset or something, you have to momentary button. Momentary button in the sense, it is like a TV remote switch on on button. Like in remote, there will be no on and off. Like if we on, it will on. If we press that button, it will on. If we again press that button, it will off. Like it is a momentary button. Next slider. If you want to add this as an output or input, you can do both. So you want to say let's find the level of the water in the tank. So you can add this one. So if it is full, the slider will be will show us full. So if you want to, let's say this as a output. So if you want to raise and reduce the volume of the TV, you can add this. So if you are sliding this to the top, it will the volume will be in the top level, like that. It is a gauge, in the sense you, if you are measuring air pressure or something, you can use this block. Then text. If you are using let's say WhatsApp or anything, you can use this text. So this is a stream. Stream in the sense, it is a live feed. We can say that it is a live feed. Then image. If you want to click an image or something, you can use this. This is a line chart. You can, if you want to analyze something in statistics, you can use a line chart. This is a color picker, and this is a map. This is a more useful block in Adafruit. This is a map. You can let's say I'm saying a project as an example. Like if you're going inside a area, like let's say Coimbatore. So if you're entering into the Coimbatore area, the Wi-Fi in our phone should automatically switch on. So there you can use map. In that you can say where are you, and if you are going into that area, Coimbatore area, you can toggle a button or something. For that you can use map. This is a remote control, totally for TV or controlling any other using remote control, you know that. And this is an icon. It is a simple one. This is an indicator. Indicator in the sense, it let's say you want to check whether the light is on or not. You can indicate. You can use the indicator block. If the light is on, the indicator will glow green. If it is off, it will not glow green. That's all. This is a number pad. You can also add number pad here. Multi-line text and dashboard link, etc. There are this much blocks in it. So let's say I'm creating a toggle button. So you have to create a name for it. Let's say toggle one for it. So we are creating it. So we have to click that and next step. So this is our toggle button. So we have to keep a title for it. As we studied earlier, each block should have a title. So I'm creating a toggle one. So the button on text will be on or off. We can change it and change 1 or 0. See, 1 or 0. So let it be on or off. See that a toggle button is created. We can switch it on and switch it off. So we are using this. If we are using a momentary button or slider, let's see a slider. I'm creating a slider one and slider one select. Next step, block title, slider one. And slider minimum value is 0, maximum value is 100. You can keep anything like let's say 1000. You can move this till 1000 value. And slider step, if your next step will be 10. It will move on like in multiples of 10. So if you are keeping 1, as if you are keeping let's say 100, you can easily see. The next value will be 200. It will go on in the multiples of 100. And slider label will be value, etc. Then create block. A slider is created. See? So you can create anything in it. Let's see the next. Here in the Adafruit, here there will be key button. This is our activate key. This key we should use as a key to our project, to our dashboard. So there will be many user creating like this in the Adafruit.io. It will consider this activate key. Okay, you should use this in this in your code, in the like here in your code you should use this. So let's see in the next part here. Adafruit setup, like I say, you are creating a dashboard, you are creating a toggle button or anything. I'm creating a Google Assistant project, so I'm doing all of this. I'm creating a relay one, and the next thing is a block setting. You're adding a title to it, and then create a toggle. See that a relay is created. So the next part is IFTTT. So if you are if you already know, the IFTTT is a app. It is a very useful app. Here it stands for IFTTT. So if this then that. So if you are this is a if else condition, as you all know. This is a if else condition. So if the water is not there, then something should happen. The water tank should pour water into it. So for that you can use this. Once again. It stands for if this then that. If something happens, then some other thing should happen. You are telling that if a thing happens, then some other things should happen. It is a free platform. You can use it in your mobile devices. Then there are two main things in the IFTTT apps. It is applets and services. Let's see what all of them. Applets, they bring your services to create experiences. An applet is a
you can add services into it, like Google Assistant or home automation, like anything. There are many home automation softwares, right? You can add these services to the applets. So if some something happens, your something happens means if a service, you can add that service. Let's say Google Assistant you are adding. So if I say switch on the light, so you can add that service, Google Assistant service, to this applet. So if you are adding this, you should put what you have to say. Then you can add a switch on the light. And if you are saying switch on the light to the Google Assistant, it will you should also add that that part. So if this, then that. So that part should be added. So if you are saying it should be added, you can use a Adafruit. Like I say, this is the Adafruit switch and off. You can switch it on or off in this IFTTT app. In this IFTTT app, you can add Adafruit as a services. So services, these are the apps and devices you can connect every day. Each service has a useful applets you can turn on. So in the older version, it will be like this. You have to sign in. It is completely free. You can sign it with Google or anything, Facebook or anything. You can sign it with that. And in the right side, these are all the services. So let's say the first thing, Google Assistant GPS navigation works with Android. So Google Assistant GPS navigation. So if you are saying where am I, it will say that you are in Coimbatore or where you are. So it will say your location. So IFTTT, these are all these services you have. You see, Adafruit is at the top, and Android devices, you can switch on Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, anything, camera, anything in this Android app. And button widget, you can control any button in your mobile itself. So let's say if you are adding this, button to your phone, it will consider this as a input. And if you are toggling it, then something will happen that you have to set up. So this is the part in the right side. You are creating a new applet. So this is the part we are adding services. So if this happens, then that will happen. So you should create this part. So you have to click on the plus icon. If you let's say I'm going to create a project. Like if we say switch on the light or switch on the fan in Google Assistant, a light or fan should switch on. So let's go with that example. So I'm adding a Google Assistant service as my this part. So I'm searching for Google Assistant. That's a Google Assistant. So this is a trigger button. So you are creating, and this part is also called trigger. So you are creating a trigger. You can say a simple phrase like switch on the light or switch on the fan, etc. In the second button, say a phrase with a number. You can the fan has a regulator, right? You can say switch on the fan and regulate it to number 5. So the fan will run in the speed of 5. So let's say a phrase with a text ingredient. So let's say a switch on the fan, off the fan, you are saying that. So on is a text ingredient. It will take on as an ingredient. So let's say a phrase with both numbers and text ingredient. You can use both in the same phrase.
See, here is a example. I'm creating a say a simple phrase trigger here. So what do you want to say? Turn on lights. You can say in any other way, right? So turn on lights, turn the lights on, you can say in any other, any way. So those are optional, but first you have to say something and others are optional. So let's say turn on lights. The second part is, what do you want the assistant to say in response? So if you are saying something to Google Assistant, it will say something in response, right? So I'm creating a turn on lights, and the assistant will say turn, I'm turning on the lights, like that the assistant will say. So we are setting the language as English and creating a trigger. Then this is the part, after the then, see. Here, we have created this part. Then we have to create that part. So in that part, here in the right side, there are so many services we can add. So if you are saying something to the Google Assistant, you have to say some tweet a message in the Twitter, or email something to somebody, email Gmail. You can use Google Drive. You should send a notification to your phone, or Google Calendar, or other services like Adafruit, Adobe. There are lot of services. We are adding Adafruit. Here, this is the connect to Adafruit. You should connect on this and authorize this. Then only you can use this service. You should sign in this with the Adafruit account. So let's say this send data to the Adafruit IO. We are sending data to the Adafruit IO that you should switch on the lamp. So here you should switch on the toggle button, or you should keep the slider at 500 or something. You can say here, send data to Adafruit IO. So you are sending a Adafruit IO. Here at first I created a feed name of relay one. So I'm selecting the feed name as relay one, and data to save as, I'm switching on right. So data to save as one. So one in the sense it will be high. So it will be switched on. So I should create action. The next thing is IFTTT setup. So here, this is a preview that if you say turn on lights, then then send data to relay one feed. Relay one in the sense Adafruit's feed, the topic relay one. We had created before. We are sending data to that relay one. Here in the sense, we are creating a toggle button. So it will say send data to toggle one. So it will send the data to the toggle button. So the next thing, this is my applet sections. Here only it will show the applets that you have created. If you say turn on lights, then send data to relay one field, it is on. So if you are saying something, it will switch on. This is the procedure. Connect the NodeMCU with the PC with the USB build. Select the port and board and correctly. Compile and upload the code. That's all. This is the procedure for a great project. This is a home automation you should all have. So Google Assistant, here I am saying an example connection to the relay. As you all know, you should give a voltage supply, Vin 5, VCC, ground, and the D1 to the line 1. Then now say, hey Google, and then turn on lights. Let's see the magic. You can see the magic that the light will on. So here is the code. Here is a IDE where you will code the example. I've sent this to Justin. One second. So this is the part I have coded for a different project. It is a similar project, like I'm creating a trigger. I'm using ultrasonic sensor as well as a light, traffic signal, motors, and traffic signal lights and motors and solenoid valve, etc., and a water flow meter, etc. Here I should include these as a compulsory, because it includes ESP8266 Wi-Fi library, and it includes Adafruit MQTT library, Adafruit MQTT client library. So here we are creating a trigger pin as a D0 and a echo pin at D3, like a sensor interrupt as 0, sensor pin as D2, these are all the D0, D3, 0, D2, these are all the pins I have, pins in the ESP8266 microcontroller. So I'm creating that, and these two lines are created for a flow rate. So I'm calculating the flow rate of the water here, and these are all the outputs I have mentioned here. So solenoid valve as the one motor. There are two motors, so motor up and down. So I'm creating D6 and D7 as a motor up and down. So I'm another for street lights. So that is for D8. So this is the Wi-Fi SSID and password to which the hardware should connect. In this case, A266 should connect to my phone hotspot or my Wi-Fi. So I'm telling to join my Wi-Fi. That is, you can give your Wi-Fi name, SSID, and you can give your password of your Wi-Fi here. The next is the Adafruit setup. So in this Adafruit setup, you have to connect to the server, right? So define AIO server Adafruit.com. You have to connect to this Adafruit.io.adafruit.com server. Then the server port here, in this case, you can use 1883. And for username John Basil, I created that dashboard, right? That is my username. And IO key, I told you, right? For Adafruit. For Adafruit, you should create a key. A key will be generated. This is the key that I have used in this code. See, this is that 16-digit key. And this is the global state. You don't want to change this, because this is a default one. Wi-Fi client, you are calling the client. Then MQTT, you are connecting to the server. So you are connecting as a client. You are connecting to the AIO server. That is IO dot, you have defined here, IO dot adafruit.com, and server port you have defined here, and username you have defined here, and key, and you have defined here. So these are all the feeds that you have created in the io.a. These are all the feeds. Toggle one, slider one, these are all the feeds that you have created. So you have to add in this path feeds. So Adafruit MQTT, so water level, this is sensor. You have to publish it to the Adafruit server. So I'm creating a publish button of the water level. So I'm sensing the water level and publish it to the Adafruit server. So Adafruit publish MQTT username, and this is the feed. And here, publish. I'm also sensing the water flow and creating a and publishing the water flows data to the username. Then light, this is the publish. So my like I want to publish, my light should be on or off. So I'm publishing the light data to the username in the Adafruit publish. And subscribe, here is a subscribe, you should get from the Adafruit server. So traffic signal, so I'm creating this light. So if this light is on, this traffic light should gets on. So I'm subscribing, right? So I'm telling that it is a subscribe button, subscribe variable, and motor, these are all the outputs, solenoid valve, street lights, etc. These are the outputs. So I'm subscribing, I'm receiving the data from the server so that the outputs may turn or off. Next, this is the code where it runs. It first of all, it connects to the MQTT server. The second, where I have told you that setup is the part where you set everything up, like your trick pin as output, you're saying trick pin, you should be output. So trick pin, here I'm saying D0 as trick pin. So here trick pin should be output, echo pin should be input, motor up should be output, motor should be output, valve should be output, street light should be output, sensor pin should be input, sensor pin, and setting sensor pin to high at first. These are all the code for these are the code for calculating the flow rate. And here it begins. Wi-Fi begin, SSID and password. It connects to our Wi-Fi, which we have Wi-Fi name and Wi-Fi password. If we give that, it will be connected to our Wi-Fi. So when it is not connected, in the delay of 500 milliseconds, so like half a second, every half a second, it will retry to connect it. That's what this line is telling. So MQTT, for subscribe alone, you have to mention this in the setup, like motor 1, you should subscribe from the MQTT server. Motor 2, you should subscribe from the MQTT server. Solenoid valve, you should subscribe from the MQTT server, like that. So the loop starts here. This is the loop where we have to code. So first of all, we are creating an MQTT connection. Second of all, I'm calling the subscription as a pointer variable here. So while subscription is here, I'm creating a subscription function, like read the subscription, like you are reading the data in the Adafruit server. So if it is on, here also it will on. So I'm creating a delay of 20 seconds to be connected. So if the subscription of the traffic signal, it will get the first, at first it will get the traffic signal subscription. So if it is if it is a 0 or 1 or something, it will serial write the on or off. So serial write, in the sense we have created a digital write, right? So here we are creating serial write. It is a that is for a digital write, is for digital things. Serial write is for like a Bluetooth connection, etc. We have to write a serial write or read. So if the subscription is motor, and I'm creating a motor state, that if it is on, here it will be on. ATOI, in the sense, ATOI, it means alpha ASCII value to integer value. So it converts ASCII value to I integer value. So everything we get from the Adafruit server, it will be in the ASCII value. So you all know ASCII value, right? So the A for something, B for something, so like that. If it is one, it will be some other thing. So it will convert it it to the integer value. So so here, let's say we are sending one. So one means high. So digital write motor down one like motor state. Here it will get the one state, and it will digital write motor value will be here one. So it means high. So I'm creating a delay for it. That is my own code. So I'm creating a delay. You can do whatever you need. So so in the subscription, when it is motor 2, the same thing happens here. So in the subscription, if it is a solenoid valve, it will get the state of the solenoid valve and digital write it to the pin which I mentioned earlier. So this is a part of the this is the part where I'm calculating the distance for a thing by using the ultrasonic sensor, and this is the part where I calculate the flow rate, and here I am publishing the water level here. See, it's not water level, I'm publishing it. And if it is, I'm also publishing the light sensor. Here I'm using for a light sensor LDR. So I'm using LDR value to be published. And this is the MQTT function which I have called before here. This is the function that I have called there. So here we are connecting it to the we are connecting to the MQTT server, and if it is not connected, then it will disconnect, and after a delay of 5 seconds, it retries. So this is the code I have done for a project.